Namaste YouTube, welcome to Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to Silent Lucidity by Queensryche.
This is on thought-provoking days on Enoma. This is a tribe request, a very popular one. I have heard this song when it came out first in the 90s. Okay. But I don't know, I've not heard it since then. So for me too, it's like a first time single take on this reaction. Let's get started right away.
Safe in bed, it was all the bad dream spinnings in your head. Your mind tricked you to feel the pain of someone close to you leaving the game of life. So here it is, another chance. Wide awake, you face the day, your dream is over, or has it just begun? There's a place I like to hide, a doorway that I child, you were there, but only didn't realize you were scared. It's a place where you will learn to face your fears, trace the years, and light the way to your mind. Set free to fly.
This was brilliant. This was astounding. This was so beautiful to listen to. I can't help but think, if I had heard this on the radio the first time in the 90s and didn't know anything about whose song it was, I would have said it was Pink Floyd. This seems so inspired by Pink Floyd's Comfortably Numb specifically, and a couple of other songs I've heard back when I was a child and a teenager. This was tremendous from Queensryche. What a song. Talks a lot about a topic that I have taken up in my classes on Sundays as well as in weekday programs of personality development, lucid dreaming. And I guess the title comes from there too. I'm smiling next to you in silent lucidity. You know, and when you're lucid dreaming, you're basically aware of the fact that you are dreaming. And so when you're in that state of awareness, you can actually conjure up images in your mind of things that you desire, things that you want, and you can play out different things in your dream because you are in control. You know, it said dream control. You are in control of what you are dreaming about, and you're aware that you're in control of it. So it's a beautiful state of mind. You know, you can take it any which way you want. You can, your soul gets wings to fly, your imagination runs wild. You can think about anything because you're still dreaming, but instead of just dreaming what your subconscious is telling you to dream about, your conscious mind is in control and you can stir your dreams any which direction that you want it to go. And that's a beautiful state of mind. I've done it several times during my meditation. In fact, practically every second day, I enter a state of lucid dreaming and I take control of my dreams. And I, you know, imagine things the way I want it to happen. You know, in a way, it's like a sense of deja vu happening. Because I want to know, I stir my dreams in exactly the way I want it to go. But at the same time, I'm still dreaming. You know, I'm still in that state of being in a dream. You know, being in my mind's dream theater or in dreamland, so to speak. And I know that I'm dreaming, but at the same time, I'm aware of it. And because of that awareness, I can stir my dream any which way I want to. So it's a beautifully put together in this song. Great song on lucid dreaming. A strong and powerful psychological phenomena and topic. I urge every listener, if you do not know much about lucid dreaming, Google it, Bing it, and learn all that you can about lucid dreaming. I'm sure on YouTube itself there may be a lot of videos, tutorials about lucid dreaming. See the credentials of the counselor, therapist, psychologist who's giving that tutorial to you. And if it's the credentials are well backed up or are sound, definitely listen to and look at what they have to say. What are your thoughts on this one, Kirti? And we call it a wrap. Want to listen to this one again? It's so close to Pink Floyd. I can't believe it. Amazing.
First of all, that voice that was narrating, kind of talking, was awesome. That was so captivating. His voice was phenomenal. Started off the song, it was amazing voice. Heavy, powerful, and you know, it gives you a direction. It does guide you. Like, he was the person who was controlling the dream.
Yeah, like and a hypnotherapist.
Yeah, and he wanted to be the controller. It's not you who has the control of the dream and of the song and listening to it. He is the controller and he is saying, I will be doing the lucid dreaming job for you. I'm the one who can do it for you. So mm-hmm. you have the control or I have the control. Let's see. I also like the line when, you know, after a few lines, he said that whether, is it reality or is it a dream? It happens with me when I'm dreaming and I'm thinking. In my dream, I know that I'm aware of this dream, but at the same time, that too is a dream. Mm-hmm. The triple dream thing. Doesn't that happen? That I'm dreaming and I think this is lucid dreaming, but that too is again a dream. So a dream is something, you know, we can't explain why it happens, what happens, and when we do master it, when we do have the ability to control it a little, I think only 10-20% of the people and 10-20% of the times we can actually control our dreams is the most powerful state of mind that we are in at that moment.
Definitely.
It is. That shows how stable mentally you are, how sane you are, how, you know, you see life in a reasonable way. Because not everybody understands what is lucid dreaming and they never experience this state of mind.
It's a great state of mind to be in to achieve your goals. You know, yeah. If you have goals to achieve, that's where you can really use lucid dreaming to program your subconscious mind, because your subconscious mind is where it's at. Yeah. It's the most powerful aspect of your thinking process, of your subliminal system, of your everything in life, of your personality. And if you can control your subconscious personality, your subconscious mind, that is when you actually gain great power over your future. And that is when you can actually achieve your goals. You can program your mind to achieve your goals. And that is why lucid dreaming is commonly used in hypnotherapy and in neuro-linguistic programming and psychology, because these are two aspects which also help program our mind to achieve our goals, to realize our dreams, or to make what we want come true in the real world. You know, because this is all a dream world while we are dreaming, whether it's lucid dreaming, whether it's NLP, whether it's hypnotherapy, it's all dreaming, it's all programming.
It is all setting your perspective, setting your control limits. How much is in your control, knowing your limits, knowing your controls, knowing how far you can reach yourself and how far your hands can reach in life and do things what you need to do. And, you know, having this kind of control over yourself, your subconscious mind is also yourself. So having the control over yourself, not anything else, helps a lot.
Definitely, because most people cannot control their conscious mind. So forget about the subconscious.
Yeah, that is true. That is
the answer. So that's what we have to say about this one. We have two counselors, teachers and parents who are reacting to this, by the way. So I would strongly urge, do research on lucid dreaming, because it definitely does help realize your dreams and helps you achieve your goals. I know, since I've been doing it for the last 10 years of my life, I have been practicing it, and it has helped me a lot, not only in reactions, but also in being a good counselor, a good trainer, and to get so many press clippings, to get millions of views for my content and generate figures of sales, or sales figures, which very few in my industry have been able to achieve in such a short span of time. So I know Lucid Dreaming works. Phenomenal song by Queensryche. Reminds me so much of Pink Floyd. But this was definitely a masterpiece on its own stand, on its own level, on its own ground. A masterpiece brilliantly done by Queensryche. Really gives you food for thought on thought-provoking days on Numb. Goodbye.
Thanks for watching.